There are many different aspects to fly fishing. The understanding of the underwater world, the interpretation of how fish and environment are connected, and the actual hunt of the targeted fish. This story follows three friends on their journey to Norway, where they get to know a breathtaking fishery and an uncommon form of river management.
My name is Tore Lidlerer-Irgren. I'm a guide in this river, and I've been guiding this river since 1990. I've also been, of course, fly fishing this river for many, many years. I know the river well, and it's been a good river for many, many years and quite popular in Scandinavia. But we have seen, since we put in the new regulations with the maximum measure in 2006, we have seen a good increase in big fish, and also an increase in spawning fish. So we produce more young fish, and we get more big fish. Grayling 50 centimeters is quite common, so we have to maybe catch a grayling of 55 to really have something to celebrate in this river.
My name is Nicolas. I'm running a small fly shop in Germany. And when I came here the first time, almost 10 years ago, I was really impressed by this river. Tore introduced me into the river really well, and the fishing was just fabulous. Over the years, I became somehow addicted to the river, fished it several times, and experienced how well it is managed. In Central Europe, good fishing usually goes hand in hand with very expensive licenses and limited access to the water. So the Reno River is a perfect example that reasonable river management can give you easy access to the water, good fishing, and a healthy river system. Now I'm back here once again to fish the Reno with my two friends Peter and Nico. Oh, we did female.
Ein Pokal für den Nikolas.
Ja, und auf den Touren, ne? Für.
Ja, auf jeden Fall.
Hier, in dieses Elchsteck.
The way the fishing is organized is that there's many private landowners that own small parts of the river, but they got together in an ownership union, kind of a syndicate, that have their own board. They decide the rules and regulations in the river, and they sell the fishing licenses to everyone. It's pretty much an open river. Everyone can come and fish, but you have to obey the regulations. And also the owners of the river, they have their own fishing police that goes around and check your licenses and that you follow the rules. This river is very rich. There's lots and lots of insects here, so the fish have enough food. And regulations based on the maximum measure is really all about keeping the fish reproducing in a natural way. And by that I mean that you keep the right genes in the river. That are really specialized in living this environment. Good ones, they grow big and they reproduce and they will get healthy small trout kids. So that's also one reason why we do this. And we see that we have really accomplished that goal. There's the number of spawning reds in the river is really going up, and we see also along the banks, we see a lot of small fish these days. 10 years ago, there was not much small fish to see along the banks. It's kind of working with nature and not against it. Was stunning. I've never fished a place like this before. I caught my biggest grayling ever and experienced a totally new kind of fly fishing in this pretty big system. At home in Germany, I fish a lot for trout, mostly in small streams with dry fly or nymph. I own a small creek myself that I operated privately. I don't stock the system with trout or other fish, and I do not kill any fish under 30 or over 40 centimeters. I own this creek for 5 years now, and the population is healthy and growing. It is very interesting to see that a big river like the Rhina can be operated and work in a similar way. It would be a great thing if more rivers or other waters in Germany would be operated the way like the Rhina, and it guarantees both a healthy population and good fishing.
Although they are located by one of the best places in the world for grayling fishing, they couldn't leave without trying out some pike fishing. And so they explored a little cove as they were searching for toothy predators.
We're moving just at the right speed.
Dreaming, but
To discover new places and new waters is always a good thing. And this trip to Riverina was absolutely awesome. We not only caught big kraling up to over 50 centimeters and had very good pike fishing too, but we also caught mid-sized and small kraling in every part of the river that we fished. And that is a sign for a healthy population, and therefore one could say that the regulations and rules on Riverina really guarantee a healthy population. And that's an interesting thing, because right now there's a big discussion in Germany going on if those maximum measures should be installed for many rivers in Germany. And yeah, maybe this example Riverina could have some positive influence on this discussion. That would be a great thing.
Positive influence on the work with the resource, water, and nature.